Rising interest rates are not good for bond prices. That's because the price of existing bonds goes down when interest rates rise. Yes, that's counterintuitive. Most people think that higher interest rates should be good for bond investors.
What's that?
It's a preferred share. It's a floating rate note. No, wait, it's Uncle Pipeline.
Hey there. I heard you're having some trouble understanding the way interest rates, also referred to as yields, affect bond prices. Allow me to break this one down for you, Jack. Let's say you bought a 10-year treasury bond in June 2016 when bond yields had bottomed. At the time, you paid $100 and locked in that 1.5% coupon, the equivalent of $1.50 per year. When yields recently hit 3%, a bond investor who just bought a newly issued bond was now getting a $3 coupon per $100 of their bond. If you wanted to sell your bond that you've owned for 2 years, you're not going to get what you paid for it. Because think about it, why would someone pay Jack $100 for a bond that pays 1.5% or $1.50, when they can just buy a new US Treasury bond at the prevailing market yield of 3% and get paid $3? Obviously, other investors would only buy your bond at a lower price that gave them the same yield as a newly issued bond.
Aw, darn!
Working out the bond math, your bond would now be worth $90. That's because, you guessed it, prices of existing bonds go down when interest rates rise. The opposite is also true. When interest rates fall, bond prices go up. Let's look at an actual 10-year treasury bond. This bond has a 2.25% coupon and matures in 10 years. The teeter-totter is flat when the yield to maturity investors demand is the same as its coupon, 2.25%. We can see the bond is priced at par, $100. But what happens to the price of this bond if investors now demand a yield to maturity 1% higher? When its yield increases 1% to 3.25%, the price now drops to $92. Inversely, we see that when the yield to maturity investors' demand decreases 1% to 1.25%, the price increases above par to $108. Now, Jack, do you see what the inverse relationship does to your bond price? That's why the interactions between bond yields and bond prices are important to understand when you're trying to figure out if you're making a good investment.
Thanks, Uncle Pipeline.